It's Valentine's week on the all-new Newlywed Game. And now, let's meet our newlywed couples for today. Couple number one. He snores so badly, she has to tell him, shut up, forget up. Newlyweds for 9 months, Charlotte and Don Walker. Couple number two. On their first date, she tried to clean his coffee table with mayonnaise and then walked off with his wallet. Married 7 months, Harleen and Jeffrey Goydell. Couple number three. They met in high school but didn't date because he was already going out with every other girl in school. Married 11 months, Sherry and Cole Graves. Couple number four. She met him at the bar where he worked, but it wasn't until later that she found out he worked as the bouncer. Married just 3 months, Angie and Russ Bragg. Those are our newlyweds for today. And here's your host, the star of the new Newlywed Game, Jim Lange.
Thank you, America. Hi, and welcome to the all-new Newlywed Game. Hey, I heard a new saying today. It goes like this. Marriage is like a revolving door. The longer you're in it, the more confused you get. Well, our couples haven't been married very long, so I'm sure they're not too confused, but then it's only the beginning of the show. And we'll be back to see just how much they really know about each other right after this message. With the wives secluded safely off stage, it's time for some five-point questions. As you know, gentlemen, you'll be answering these questions, and you predict your wife will answer the same question when she returns. If her answer matches your prediction, you'll chalk up 5 points towards a grand prize selected especially for you. Now listen carefully, gentlemen. Remember, each question is worth 5 points. Each correct prediction brings you closer to your exciting grand prize. So here we go. First question, gentlemen. After your wife takes a shower, will she say she dries herself from head down, from the toes up, or starts somewhere in the middle? Russ, we're going to give you a chance to go first. How does your wife dry herself?
Jim, Angie is so organized that she would start from the head down.
From the head down?
Head down.
All right. Cole, how about Sherry?
I'd probably say somewhere in the middle because that's probably the way she is most of the time.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen her do this?
Oh, yeah, many times.
All right.
Every day.
Jeffrey, how does Harleen dry herself?
Harleen dries herself from the top on down, but by the time she's down on the bottom, she has to redo her top. She doesn't like the way her hair came out.
Okay, very good. You're very observant. And Don, how about Charlotte?
Head down, most definitely.
Head down. Okay, next question, gentlemen. How many pints of blood would your wife say she has in her body? Okay.
Many pints of blood?
You go first this time.
Your wife thinks she has
probably three.
Three.
I would think.
Your
she doesn't know
three.
Anything about it, probably.
Okay. We'll wait and see. Jeffrey.
We just went to donate blood. I think they said seven.
Seven. Your answer is seven. Good. Don?
I'll say five. Five pints.
Five for Charlotte.
For Charlotte, for
okay,
sure.
And Russ?
I'll save five for Angie also. I think she had a little bit of anatomy and physiology, so.
Okay,
you say five.
Gonna be five. All right, gentlemen. Here's your next question. How will your wife complete this sentence? Now, this is her talking, okay? You gotta put this in your mind. To avoid big trouble, the one thing I've learned since we've been married is to never, never blank when my husband gets romantic. She's learned that. All right, Jeffrey, what has Harleen learned?
She's learned never not to use perfume when I get romantic because once I said she smelled like a moose. So she now knows to use perfume.
Don't use perfume.
No, to use perfume
to
she doesn't smell like a moose.
All right, Don.
She'll say never. Can you repeat the question?
Okay, sure. This is her speaking now. To avoid big trouble, the one thing she's learned since you've been married is to never, never what when you get romantic?
Say no.
Oh, I hate that.
Gotcha. Say no. Russ?
Definitely say no. You got to remember, I'm the guy that she met at the bar, so.
Okay. Angie, it's also no is a no-no.
Right.
Okay, and finally, Cole, what will Sherry?
Probably bat her eyelashes at me because I'm probably ready in a second.
All right. Thank you very much, gentlemen. We'll be right back to reunite the newlyweds and see how well a husband can predict what their wives will say right after these messages. All right, gentlemen, we have recorded your predictions on cards. You now have them in your laps. And each time your prediction matches your wife's answer, you'll get 5 points. And the couple with the most points at the end of the show will win a grand prize selected especially for them. First question, ladies. After you take a shower, do you dry yourself from the toes up, from the head down, or do you start somewhere in the middle? Charlotte.
Mine to me.
I just took a shower. Okay. From the head down.
From the head down. Don said.
You're right.
Don said, from the head down. Hi, Marley. How do you dry yourself?
From the head down. But then I go back to my head and do a real good job on the hair.
Then just move down.
Right. Okay. The second time.
Jeffrey said, from the head down. Okay. You have 5 points. All right, Sherry. How do you dry yourself? Now think back.
Not long ago. From the head down.
From the head down?
Yeah.
Cole told us you start somewhere in the middle, Sherry.
That's you that start somewhere in the middle.
Everywhere in the middle.
You got in the middle.
All right, Angie. Angie, how do you dry yourself?
From the head down.
From the head down. Russ told us you dry yourself from the head down, and you have 5 points. And we have a three-way tie. Couples 1, 2, and 4. Next question, ladies. How many pints of blood do you have in your body? Easy enough. Arlene.
12. I'm bad at anything that has to do with the body, and that's just a guess. And it's probably a bad guess, but...
You think you're bad at that?
I know a lot of Dracula-type people.
Yeah. Jeffrey told us you had 7.
Seven? That's worse than 12.
I don't know. We went to donate blood, and they said you were anemic, but I don't remember how much blood you had.
Sherry. Or wait a second. Yeah, Sherry.
Oh, gosh. 3?
3. 3! That's a tough one. That's a tough one. 3, huh? Wow. Angie.
10.
10. All right. Russ told us you would say 5.
5. Even with all your nursing, too.
I wanted to be a nurse. I don't know how many pints of blood are in the body. All right. And finally, Charlotte.
I'm supposed to know this because I have a bachelor's of science.
Well, Don gave us an answer.
I'm just going to say 10.
You're going to say 10?
Yeah.
Don told us you had 5 pints of blood in your body.
I'm sorry.
All right, that's the end of that question, and it's a tie. Flat tie. All 4 couples have 5 points. Here's the next question. Ladies, how would you complete this sentence now? And this is you talking, okay? To avoid big trouble, the one thing I've learned since we've been married is to never, never what when my husband gets romantic. Something to avoid. Sherry.
Gosh, that's a tough one. He's a big guy. go to sleep.
That's a no-no. He said, never bat your eyelashes, Sherry. Does that get to him a little bit?
Oh, I don't know.
You do now. All right, Angie?
Never give in.
Never give in. And get to him. All right, Russ said... You should never say no. Never, just the opposite. All right, Angie. Okay, Charlotte, what do you think John said?
Say no.
Never say no. He said no. Yeah! And finally, Arlene, what should you never, never do when Jeffrey gets romantic?
Never put Vaseline on my lips.
I hate when she does it. You're in the middle of it, and she reaches over to the jar and starts putting it on her lips.
Never put Vaseline on your lips. Jeffrey told us you should never not use perfume.
Oh, yeah.
Why do you, does she have to use perfume?
She likes perfume, and I hate it.
Once I told her she smelled like a not-so-great animal.
and she should use perfume.
I think she'll remember that. Thank you very much, couples, and we'll be back with just the wives to see how well they predict what their husbands will say right after Rod Roddy tells us about the gift we have for our runner-up couple. Right?
It's Mr. Coffee, America's number one coffee maker. Genuine Mr. Coffee accessories with extra decanter and Mr. Coffee filters. Plus a generous supply of Kentucky Fried Chicken. Tender and juicy bite after bite of Kentucky Fried Chicken. We do chicken right. And Niagara, America's number one selling spray starch. Helps prevent the deep penetration of dirt and soil with crisper, firmer finish with Niagara spray starch. And the Hoover Portapower Vacuum. All the power of a full-size vacuum in a compact, lightweight canister. The Portapower from Hoover. Now let's go back to Jim Lange and those ever-fascinating newlyweds.
All right, ladies, now your husbands are secluded off stage, and it's your turn to predict what they will say. Now, each of these questions will be worth 10 points. 10 points, so here we go. First question, ladies. What will your husband say is the silliest thing of yours that he ever put on in the house? Marty.
I'll say my sleeping shirt.
He put on your sleeping
shirt? Yeah.
Okay, got it.
How we wear the same size, and it's comfortable, and...
Okay, Charlotte.
My shower cap.
Okay. He does that often?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Okay. Angie?
My bra.
What was your answer?
I don't want to explain this.
Well, I didn't...
My bra. Not often, just...
Just occasionally, yeah. Russ put your bra.
Well, okay. Not where it belongs.
And Sherry.
I don't think he's ever put anything of mine on, but I'll say my robe.
Your robe, okay. Ladies, here's your next question. How will your husband say you would complete this sentence? This is you talking. Now, when it comes to dancing, if Michael Jackson is a perfect 10, then I'd rate my husband a blank because he moves like a what? We're looking for two answers, and we're going to start with Charlotte. How would you rate your husband? A number, and then he moves like what?
I'd rate him a 9. Because mm-hmm. He moves like Michael Jackson's twin.
Michael Jackson's twin. Okay. Angie?
I'd give him a 10 mm-hmm. because he moves like Michael Jackson.
Oh, another Michael Jackson. Okay, Sherry?
Boy, I'd give him a 10. But because he moves like, God, he's all over the place. like King Kong?
King Kong! And Harley.
I'll say a 10 at 10. He moves like Michael Jackson. He's a good dancer.
Michael Jackson. Very good.
I'm a terrible dancer.
Here's your bonus question, ladies. This is very important. We're 25 points. What room in your home will your husband say lies closest to the Canadian border? That's all. Your husbands must match, or your answers must match exactly. The room in your house closest to the Canadian border, Angie.
The living room.
Living room. Sherry.
The dining room.
Dining room. Harleen.
The den.
The den. And Charlotte.
The living room.
The living room. All right. Thank you very much, ladies. And we'll be back with the husbands to compare answers on the Newlywed Game right after these messages. But first, let's take a look at today's newlyweds just after their wedding. Welcome back to the Newlywed Game, and we have a very close game. Couple number one has 10, the other couple's 5, but there's a lot more to go. And now, gentlemen, let's see how well your wives have predicted what you will say. Remember, these questions will be worth 10 points. First question. Guys, what is the silliest thing of your wife's that you've ever put on in the house? And we'll start with Cole. Cole?
Silliest things.
Mm-hmm. Something of your wife's that you put on.
Robe.
A robe.
Her robe.
A robe, Sherry said. Your robe, and you got it, and you have 15, and you're in the lead. Russ.
Yeah, I'm going to have to go with robe, too.
You say... She said... Her bra!
Don't you?
Yeah, it's a superstructure, but I... No, I put on a robe to answer the door once, and yeah. It was one of my friends, and they kind of looked at me.
You totally denied the brawler.
No.
I tried it almost. Just for a bit.
Not okay. In the right place.
I'm sorry to say no points on that one, Russ, okay? Don.
A shower cap.
You put on a shower cap? She said shower cap, and you got 10 more points, and you're in the lead with 20. And finally... Jeffrey, what did you put on him, Harleen's?
I guess I have to say a bathrobe because I don't
know. You put on a bathrobe?
Yeah.
Okay, she said her sleeping shirt. Her sleeping shirt. Do you remember that?
I have the same one. Why would I wear yours?
You have another one.
Which one?
The like t-shirt one that's a knit with a little short sleeve because yours is dirty.
I'll bet he looked cute in it too.
It was pink.
No points for you on that one, and we have a brand new question. Couples, how did your wife complete this sentence, guys? This is her talking now. When it comes to dancing, if Michael Jackson is a perfect 10, then I'd rate my husband a what? Because he moves like a what? We need a number, and what do you move like? Russ?
See, if Michael Jackson's a 10, mm-hmm. I'd have to be about a minus 5.
Minus 5. Because you move like?
Probably because I move like a giraffe.
Uh-huh. Angie told us that you were... A 10, because you move like Michael Jackson.
Ooh.
Ah.
I know how much you
Don.
I say a 10 because I do gymnastics when I dance sometimes.
So you move like a what?
I move like a gymnast.
You move like a gymnast. 10, you move like a gymnast. Charlotte said you're a 9 because you're Michael Jackson's twin.
Isn't that nice?
A nice compliment, but no points. All right, Jeffrey, what do you think Harleen said?
I guess about a 5 because I'm and
move like
probably because she says I always dance with my fists in the air, kind of like a prize fighter.
Okay, you're 5, you dance like a prize fighter. Harleen said you were a 10 because you dance like Michael Jackson.
Dancing is so good,
but you always make fun of it.
But that's because you make fun of mine.
That's what I thought, what you thought, so you think it's bad. I think it's okay.
No point. All right, Cole, what do you think Carrie said about you?
I'd probably be a 9, but. I suppose it would probably be because I'm pretty freestyle. You got to clear the floor for me to dance.
Dance like a
construction worker. I don't know.
A construction worker. Sherry said you were a 10 because you dance like King Kong. Great, guys. And we'll be back with a 25-point bonus question to see which couple win our grand prize right after this recess. All right, gentlemen, here is your 25-point bonus question. Very important at the moment. Couple number 1, Charlotte and Don lead with 20 points. And in second place, couple number 3, Sherry and Cole. And I'm sorry to say couples 2 and 4 are in last place at 5. But don't be despairing because anybody can still win. This is a 25-point question. Here it is, gentlemen. What room in your home lies the closest to the Canadian border? Your answers must match exactly. That's our bonus question for 25 points. We start with couple number 2, Harleen and Jeffrey. And I'll tell you, Jeffrey, you have 5. If you get the 25 points, you will go from last, where you've been all during the show, to first place and a chance for that big, big prize. Okay, what room in your house is closest to the Canadian border?
This is easy. It's north, so the northernmost room in our house is the bedroom.
The bedroom. Harleen said... The den.
I don't
know direction.
Yeah, the bedroom sticks out there.
Go to couple number 4. You have the same opportunity. 25 points. If you get it, you're in first place. Go from last to first. The closest room in the house to the Canadian border. What is it, Russ?
The living room.
The living room. Angie said, the living room! You have 35, so you take the lead. All right, couple number 3. Sherry and Cole, you have 15. With 25, that'll give you 40 and will vaunt you past Angie and Russ into first place, and you could take home that fabulous prize selected just for you. Cole, which room in your house?
Probably the family room.
The family room. Sherry says the dining room. The dining room.
It's in the front of the house. That's
and now we go to couple number 1. Charlotte and Don, you have 20. If you get the 25 points, you have 55 points, and you are our grand prize winners. If you miss it, Angie and Russ, you win it all. This is it. For 25 points, tell me, Don, the room in your house closest to the Canadian border.
I don't. Ew, no. My favorite room is the bedroom.
The bedroom. Charlotte said the living room, and that means couple four. Angie's house. Grand prize winner for today. And now Angie and Russ, today's winners are really a game. Here's a special prize chosen just for you. A sleek 12-foot motorboat.
It's an exciting new sport boat. From Delta West, it's a paper craft designed to perform with both speed and agility. It comes complete with an 18 horsepower Tohatsu outboard motor and trailer and winch. You'll enjoy the thrilling high-performance action that makes the Vapor Vet a favorite for sport boating and water skiing. And just so you won't be stranded on dry land, here's a brand new pair of motor scooters. Fully automatic with electric starter, a sporty luggage rack, and it's designed to run economically. Have fun and congratulations from the new Newlywed Game.
Congratulations to Angie and Russ. And thanks to all of you. You played very well, and may you have long and happy marriages. And especially thanks to you for being with us. Until tomorrow, this is Jim Lang. Goodbye for now. And remember, you don't have to be a newlywed to act like one.
Take to be a Hollywood player.
Number one box office movie, Titanic. Ow! Oh, Tricky's contract is so hot it burns, baby. Gotta run. Something important just came up.
What's it take to be a Hollywood player? Simple. Just play the game. Hollywood Showdown, weeknights 8 Eastern on Game Show Network.
Oh, watch the hands, pal.
This is the NBC Television Network.
It's time for the match game. Hollywood Square. Our quiz from real people, Skip Stevenson. Allison Arngren. Jimmy Walker. Wyla Littleton. Bill Proctor. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Square's Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bellman.
Thank you. All right.
Here we go. We welcome you one and all to the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. This is the marriage of two of your favorite TV games. I'll be hosting Match Game.
And later on, I'm going to be hosting Hollywood Squares.
Why don't we get to work and do that right?
Good idea.
Would you have a seat over here, John, please, while I say hello, stars?
Hello, Mr. Rayburn.
How are you?
Hello.
Mr. Rayburn.
Mr. Rayburn.
You may call me Jeans.
Thank you, Mr. Jeans.
All right. Nice to see all of your bodies.
Thank
You're
you.
Beautiful.
Some of the bodies, it's nice to see more than the other ones, isn't it?
That's right. Yes. Well, these two over here.
Depends
especially.
On your point of view.
Yes. Well, you're all lovely. And now that I've greeted you, let's give a warm greeting to our two contestants over here, Laurie Gause and David Bentley.
Yes.
Hello. Welcome.
Thank you.
Laurie, we'd like to find out a little bit about you, if you please.
Okay, I'm Laurie Gause. I'm from Hemet, California. I have two children, and in Hemet, I'm a health instructor.
Really?
Yes.
Is it hot in Hemet?
It's hot.
It is hot. Well, we hope you are hot here in this game and win some money here. David, welcome to you. Tell us about you, please.
Hi, Gene. I'm David Bentley. I'm single. I live in Los Angeles, and I'm currently involved in co-producing educational films.
That sounds like a worthwhile venture.
Thank you.
And may I point out to you as we begin here that on Match Game, each of you will have an opportunity to match as many of our celebrities as you possibly can. We play three rounds. The contestant who has matched the most celebrities at the end of the game will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares and for a chance to win up to $30,000. All right. Won the toss, so we're going to ask her to go first. Do you have a selection here of A or B?
We'll go with B.
B it is for Laurie. We're off and running. Norm said,
Norm,
it's time to start worrying about your teenage son when he tells you he wants to be a blank when he grows up. That's the time to worry about your teenage son when he says, I want to...
Have you ever been to Hemet?
Yeah, I've been to Hemet.
It's real hot in Hemet. Mm-hmm. It's an hour later, too.
Is it?
An hour later. Yeah, your son wants to be a blank.
Time to start worrying about your teenage son when he tells you he wants to be a blank when he grows up.
I think that's a good answer.
It is.
Back here.
All right. Okay.
I'm lit up.
As long as you're all lit up. That's the idea here. Laurie, Norm said it's time to start worrying about your teenage son when he tells you he wants to be a blank when he grows up.
Let's try a model.
A model?
A model?
A model.
How many of us?
Well, I don't know. I'll try one.
Yeah. You want to try a model?
I would like to try a model anytime she'll let me.
All right, Jimmy. She
it's
says
being
model.
A model. There's a lot of male models.
So sure.
You think nothing they're all a little...
Name two. Name two.
There's Bill Jones and there's John Smith.
Tom
anyway, they
George
both...
Hamilton started as a
model. George Hamilton started as a model? Hot.
Go, Jimmy.
Fine. I figured since maybe... He was in trouble. I figured that maybe you're in trouble when he wants to become a Rockette.
A Rockette. Right.
Yes, a Rockette would be serious.
Start
problems.
Worrying about your teenage son when he tells you he wants to be a blank when he grows up. And she said model.
And I said girl.
A girl. All right. All right, two good answers. No awing. Those are good answers. Don't awe the good answers. Twyla?
Now, I'll be a little more realistic. However, I am a model. But let's see. How about rock star?
A rock star. Right. There is nothing wrong with being a model, is there?
No.
All right.
There's nothing wrong with being a girl, really, if you think about it.
Nothing wrong with being Twyla Little.
Some people enjoy it.
Time to start worrying about your teenage son when he tells you he wants to be a model when he grows up, according to Laurie.
Well, I would have matched Phil Proctor's answer, girl, but I figured he had grown up and become a woman.
A woman.
I don't have an answer now. They've given all my answers. I figured that the worst thing that could possibly happen to a father... have his son grow up to be an unemployed person.
Unemployed person. And right, continuing to live at home. Right. That's okay. Yeah.
They agree?
Yeah.
Kind of like a blank.
Allison, what do you have to say about this?
Well, I think that unemployed or a rock star probably isn't too bad, but if your son says he wants to grow up to be a woman...
Then you know you're in trouble. All right, Laurie. You had a good response. We had some good responses there, too, but no match for you so far. David, let's see what we've got for you. George has no class.
You're kidding.
No. When the waiter brought the finger bowl, he used it to wash his blank. Yeah.
That's good.
That's a French.
All right.
That's a French belly, yeah.
Here we go. George has no class. When the waiter brought the finger bowl, he used it to wash his...
His feet.
His feet. I think that's a good response, David.
Yeah.
Feet. Not bad. Jimmy?
I figured the lowest, horriblest thing you can do would be to wash your hair. Real bad. Lemon hair thing like they have. Those lemon things.
Squeeze a little lemon in the finger bowl.
Yes.
All right, well,
you know, this happens in French restaurants, the good restaurants, and it's always good to clean your palate before you eat. So I said he cleaned his tongue.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I don't know if we want to go on with this, do we? All right.
I don't know, because I have a feeling that I have no class either. I said wash your mouth out.
Wash your mouth out.
Kind of the same.
All right. Well, no, the object of this game is not determining whether you have class or not, Twyla. It's this guy,
George
over here. He's the one.
No class.
What do you say? No class. When the waiter brought the finger bowl, he used it to wash his.
I tried to think of all the things I could possibly spill on, and I thought this was one of the most likely. His tie.
He used it to wash his tie.
Yeah.
All right. Skip, what do you say?
Well, I got worse than that. I don't know if this is class or not, but he used it to wash his underwear.
That's low.
Is that low? That's pretty low,
Pretty D-class A, if you ask me.
Not far down as a sock,
though.
That's
why you're sitting down there.
That's right. Lower. Allison?
And as we move lower and lower down the body, well, it's not feet, but it's real close. Socks?
Socks.
We got the laundry done.
All right. So there you are. No match so far for either Laurie or for David. That's the end of round one. Round two will be up in a moment or so. But first, we want you to watch these messages.
I like to feel fresh. Fresh as a country lane after a spring shower.
I like to feel fresh and confident.
It's simple with Summer's Eve, the most convenient disposable douche you can buy. This exclusive one-piece unit means there's nothing to assemble, and it's available in two fragrances, or vinegar and water, the solution doctors recommend. With Summer's Eve, freshness has never been simpler.
Here we go with round two. Thank you all. We finished round one, and as you can plainly see, we've got a tough battle going here. Zip to zip is the score.
Egg wars.
And since it's tied, Laurie went first last time, so David will ask you to go first this time. A or B, if you please.
Let's go with B.
B it is for you. B says, Mean Minnie. Mean Minnie.
Yeah.
Mean Minnie.
Is such a... Wait a minute.
We gotta
tell you how mean she is. Get your own show. Mean Minnie is such a rotten mother, she didn't abandon her baby on a doorstep. She left him on the blank.
I think I got it.
It's a long answer.
It is?
It's not the wrong answer, but it's a long answer.
All right.
Okay.
There we go. All right, David. Mean Minnie is such a rotten mother, she didn't abandon her baby on a doorstep. She left him on the blank.
On the street.
On the street.
Ooh. Mean street.
Yeah.
Mm.
Oh. What street was that?
It was Slauson off ramp.
Slauson, before you get to Avalon. Moving down the freeway.
All right.
What is the answer? Street?
Yeah, oh, street is the answer.
I said curve, which has to be the correct answer, of course. No doubt about it.
Sorry.
No.
Now, wait a minute.
Get out of here. Let's go.
He knows the street.
Quiet. Get back in your seat. Get me the whip out here. The curb is close to the street, Jimmy, but it is not exactly the street.
I can't deal with it. Call my agent.
Please. My train of thought was, of course, more like the 3rd Avenue L, which they tore down. I said she was so mean she left her baby on the delivery room table.
That would be mean.
That's
fine. Now, I think mine is even more mean. I said the hospital floor.
That was a mean mother. I don't know whether we wanted her to be that mean or not. Mean Minnie, rotten mother, didn't abandon her baby on a doorstep. She left him on the...
Well, see, in the gutter.
Closer
to the street can you get?
Wait a minute. Hold on now.
This is a brand new show, isn't it?
That's right.
Are they going to give away any money at all?
We're trying not to.
I guess we get to split it, huh?
I had the same weird thought that the person up above me had, the operating table. Still, I think you should give him some money anyway. Yeah. To make
well, we will try and work that out. It's a low-budget show, Skip. Allison, what have you got for us?
Well, curbs and gutters, that's fairly cruel, but I figure if you really want to be mean, you leave your baby on the freeway.
It's a street.
That's one.
Freeway.
They felt abandoned on the freeway.
I hope you have nice parting gifts.
There is one. That was a match.
That's a match, and curb is not a match.
Gutter is not a match.
Now, hold on. Now, wait a minute. Maybe we can appeal to the judges and reason with them.
No, there's no reasoning with
them. We can't reason with these
gutter,
animals.
The gutter, which is on this side, see, if this were the curb right here, you see.
This is humiliating.
They are.
And this is the street right here.
Humiliating.
No, the curb is here.
It's like a button on a shirt.
The gutter would be right here.
It's all where the gutter is. Curb, I understand, yeah. But gutter is...
We lost.
Hey, the Nicholas brothers are
nice
working
try.
Again.
That's great. All right, one for David. Let's see what we've got for Laurie Gauze. Harry said,
The
doctors who performed my heart transplant were really immature. In the middle of my operation, I woke up, and they were playing blank with my heart.
Oh.
Bunch of immature... surgeons.
I want to talk to those judges privately.
Dye your hair blonde.
All right, Skip, you ready?
I'll just have to do this.
Put that in the slot there.
Sorry.
We go to Laurie. Harry said the doctors who performed my heart transplant were really immature. In the middle of my operation, I woke up and they were playing blank with my heart.
Catch.
Playing catch. Very good. I think that's good.
Good answer.
He said, playing catch.
Good answer.
I said, curb. No. No, I said, this is probably not a match. I maybe have to go to the judges. Catch, maybe we can get a match on this. Maybe.
What have you got for us, Phil?
I said, a cat. I mean, catch.
Catch. Uh-huh. Hey, Laurie. We're on a roll now.
Well, I'm way off base.
Yeah. Are you?
I said tic-tac-toe.
Tic-tac-toe. Oh. And we're going to play that a little bit later.
I get it.
Yeah. I don't like people with those kinds of thoughts.
2-1 for Laurie. The doctors were immature. In the middle of my heart transplant operation, I woke up and they were playing catch with my heart, according to Laurie.
Well, this is a game I used to play in the gutter when I was
standing on the curb.
An immature child in New York City. Punch ball.
You wouldn't want to.
All right. No man's there.
Well, I figured that these doctors were not only, they were a little bit sadistic. They were only playing catch, they were playing keep away.
Keep away.
Is that close? That's sketch. Without a
funny.
Yeah.
Funny, but you know, keep away is sketch.
No, that's
not a match.
No.
This is a popular song.
No, that's part of it.
I think that works as a match for me.
Yeah.
Here we go with Allison.
Well, I thought since they were so immature, I tried to go for the dumbest game I could come up with was hot potato.
Hot potato. All right.
Tic-tac-toe.
So there we are, 2-1. Laurie is ahead, and that's the end of round two. We'll go to round three, the final round, right after this.
Just compare Pillsbury Already Pie Crust to Scratch Crust.
Bet you can't tell which crust is scratch and which one is already. Bet you can't tell which crust is scratch and which one is Pillsbury. Real fresh dough, just unfold it. Bake it, taste just like you roll.
Grandmothers. Now, Laurie, you're ahead, 2-1. That means you go first, A or B.
Hey, let's go with A.
A it is. A says, Farmer Joe said.
Yeah.
My cow is really stubborn. Everything I tell it goes in one ear and out the blank.
We can have a good time up here, all by ourselves.
That's right.
Right? Ready, Twyla? All right, Laurie. Farmer Joe said, my cow... Skip.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You have to push it all the way in.
All the way
in.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, all right.
He's all the way in.
You know about that. Skip.
Yes, I do.
Farmer Joe said, my cow
I'm not gonna. No.
Is really stubborn.
No. I didn't say a word. No, standards and practices are here. Hello, standards. Hello, practices.
One show on the air at a time, if you please. My cow is really stubborn. Everything I tell it goes in one ear and out the blank.
Tail end.
Oh!
Obvious. Too obvious.
Lori, what were the other things?
Lori. Out the other.
Out the other?
Yeah.
She thought the popular answer was out the other.
All right. These people.
Twyla, what do you say to that? I tell it goes in one ear and out the...
I don't think I said that.
You didn't?
I said milk.
That's good.
That doesn't make sense to me.
When you look like Twyla, you can get away with those dumb answers.
That's good.
Who's crazy is these celebs?
All right.
That doesn't even work.
Here we go, John. Everything I tell you goes in one ear and out the...
I believe this is the definitive answer. The udder.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Out the udder.
I like this idea of putting two game shows together, because we're putting our shows together, too. It's called Real Incredible People. It's going to be...
I don't know exactly how you spell this, but is out the udder?
Like
that? Well, that's
we would have allowed that if she had said udder.
Yeah.
Allison?
Oh. It's a cow, you know? It goes moo, and it's got an udder.
Udder.
Moo!
Well, Laurie, you had a lock on it, and now you've given David a chance to creep up on you here. He's still behind, 2-1.
Never
Let's
give David
happens.
A chance to creep up on you, too.
Right.
I found that out, yeah.
The teacher said,
"Yes,
I knew little Louis would grow up to be a crook. Whenever he wanted my attention, he'd hold up a blank." You would understand that. Allison doesn't play this round because she matched David in the previous round.
I like that theme music. It's got a little rhythm to it.
Yes.
Brother.
Well, all right, Twyla's ready. So, David, we come to you. The teacher said, "I knew little Louis would grow up to be a crook. Whenever he wanted my attention, he'd hold up a blank."
He'd hold up a bank.
He'd hold up a bank. All right. David, you need 1 to tie and 2 to win.
Judges
he needs 1 to tie and 2 to win. Jimmy, what do you say?
The thing about this question is there was 2 excellent answers. And me and David were thinking along the same line. Only he came up with the other excellent answer. I said student.
Hold up a student.
That's right. That's kind of how it was.
All right. I think the judges are going to have to get ready for another gutter fight, frankly.
Uh-oh.
But I said piggy bank.
Oh.
Thank you.
Right. Score is tied. 2-2. One more match, and David wins the game.
Oh, my
goodness.
Well,
I thought since he probably wasn't old enough to go out of the neighborhood, that he would hold up the neighbors.
Hold up the neighbors. That's a good response. All right. 2-2.
They go on the curb and drink some milk. Yeah.
I knew little Louis would grow up to be a crook. Whenever he wanted my attention, he'd hold up a...
I'm sorry, I was in a different street entirely, and my answer's in the gutter. I said a gun.
Hold up a gun. David's looking for a bank, Skip. What have you got for him?
I started out to say bank. I thought that would be funny.
Yeah.
And then I thought if you're going to rob a bank, you'd have to have a gun like he did. So I didn't have it. But
the game ends in a tie. All right. Now we're going to go to our tiebreaker to find out which one our winner is. Here we go to the tiebreaker. I push this button with my magic finger. And there is the tie-breaking question. Here it is.
Oh, my goodness.
Blank, New Jersey. Blank, New Jersey. Now, in front of you, but out of sight of the panel, are 4 good answers to that question. We want you to pick what you think is the best answer by number. David, we'll begin with you. Don't say any words. Just give me a number.
Number one.
All right. You got that. You hang on to that for a while. Now, you may pick an answer from the remaining ones, if you please.
Number three.
You've got number three. I'm going over here, and I'm going to ask our celebrities to give us their best answer to blank New Jersey. As soon as you hear the answer, which you have in front of you there, you've got to take a peek at it, you let me know loud and clear. This will be verbal responses from you, if you please. Jimmy, how do you fill in that blank? Blank New Jersey.
You know where I'm from. I'm from the South Bronx, but closest to the South Bronx is Newark.
Yeah. Newark, New Jersey. Lori Gause is our winner. Congratulations. She's making her way down here. We're going to thank David Bentley for being our guest here on Match Game. Many prizes for you coming your way. Thank you, David Bentley. All right. Now
Now it's time to switch to Hollywood Squares, and look at that marvelous piece of furniture coming in here. There it is. We're going to bring on three more celebrities. I'm going to trade places with John Bauman, the host of Hollywood Squares. So don't go away. We'll be right back for lots more excitement.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar's stylish video cassette recorder, combines the convenience of front loading with the performance of a true track forehead system furnished by Quasar. And some of our departing contestants will receive West Bend Stir Crazy Automatic Caramel Corn Maker. Fast and easy to use because it serves itself with great tasting popcorn, caramel corn, or cheese corn. Be everything you can be with Mary Kay Cosmetics, skincare, and glamour cosmetics, presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics. New Hager jeans. Now the fit, comfort, and styling you expect from Hager can help you look and feel your best even when you're wearing jeans. Silverstone on Steel by Bake King. Easier food removal, faster cleanup. Silverstone on Steel by Bake King. The crowning touch on bakeware today. Clothing by Adobe. Share your special feelings with Care Bears Kidswear. All the love of the Care Bears in soft, lovable style. Care Bears Kidswear by Adobe. And now, it's time for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Square. Hour. With. What we've got today, Tom DeLarge. Harvey Benson. Bill Daly. And taking over, the star of Hollywood Square, John Bauman. And we'll be right back.
There are. The Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Now I have with me Stacey Gause, who has just won the Match Game contest and is now ready to take on our returning champion in Hollywood Squares. Let's get right into action. Here we go. Now, since this is our very first show, we don't actually have a returning champion. So before the show, we drew lots and Stacey Turner won. Welcome to you, Stacey.
Thank you.
Listen, if you play well enough, you might get to be our real champion. Why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm from Independence, Missouri, and I recently graduated.
Show me.
I recently graduated from Trinity University in San Antonio, Texas, and majored in drama, and came out here to find my fortune.
Well, terrific. This is a good place for it, because you could find your fortune after we play Hollywood Squares. We're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever is ahead at that time is the winner, goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. They won it. Okay, our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that you capture. Our champion gets to start. Stacy, pick a square. Let's go.
Pick Tom Villard.
Tom Villard.
On the spot.
I'm ready.
Attaboy. According to the Kinsey Institute, Tom, who is more likely to make love with his clothes on? A man with a college education or a man with only a high school education?
No, that's not serious.
You can poll our panel if you like.
A man with a college education.
Okay. Tom says a man with a college education is more likely to make love with his clothes on. Agree or disagree, Stacy?
I disagree.
It's a man with a high school education. You are right to disagree. You get the first square and $25.
I'd take off that suit if I were him, actually.
The real answer is a man in a hurry.
I don't see how that happens.
Okay, you're off to a good start, Stacy. Lori, your chance to get on the board.
Okay, let's go with Twyla.
Oh, mm-hmm. Thank you.
I'd love to go with Twyla. Twyla.
Yes, sir.
Wouldn't you all? In a recent 17 magazine poll, Twyla, the majority of teenage girls said that going there was the ideal date. Going where?
Homecoming dance.
Okay, so she says going to the homecoming dance was the ideal date. Agree or disagree, Lori?
I'll disagree.
The answer is to the movies. You are right to disagree, and you get the square and $25.
I think that one was like 17.
Well, you can't go to the homecoming dance that often, most likely. That's probably
but
the
it
point.
Is a great date.
Hell of a date. Stacy, you're up.
Phil Proctor, please.
You're welcome.
Philip.
So polite.
You have all heard the children's song, Pop Goes the Weasel.
Speak for yourself.
I just read what's on the card.
Does the term pop goes the weasel mean?
I just heard the weasel go pop. Did you hear that? Go ahead.
Does the term pop goes the weasel mean taking something to a pawn shop or hitting a rodent with a stick?
No, it means taking something to a pawn shop.
Mm-hmm. Phil says that pop goes the weasel means taking something to a pawn shop. You going to agree or disagree with that, Stacy?
I disagree.
The answer is taking something to a pawn shop. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square. Laurie Gause, take a good look at the board. Tell me where you would like to go. There's
okay.
A good spot.
Jimmy Walker to win.
I'm a winner already?
No, you're not going
to win. What? Do I get the 30 grand?
No. She wins you.
Oh, she wins me. Wow. What a prize.
Now, Laurie may be a winner if you can get through this question, Jimmy.
Let's get through it.
According to the book, Singles, the New Americans.
That's me, Mr. America.
Are newly divorced women more likely to lose weight or to gain weight?
Wow. Well, they may have gotten divorced because they were too tubby anyway. Say, well, some people are a little overweight. There's nothing I can do about that. I myself, I'm very slim and trim. I buy most of my clothes Beverly Hills, a store called Mr. Pencil. Can you see it?
Very elegant.
Yeah. But I would say when women get divorced, they're very gung-ho to change their lives, change mm-hmm. their hair, get a new nose, get new things happening in their lives. So they go to the gym and they meet guys and they do things so they lose weight.
Okay.
Very logical.
Thank you.
I think Jimmy said that they're more likely, newly divorced women are more likely to lose weight. This is for the game, Laurie. Do you agree or disagree?
I'm going to agree.
And the answer is lose weight. You're right to agree and you win the game. Well done, Laurie. You won the game. You won $100 with the squares you had up there. That gives you $175 so far. And we will be back to play our $200 game right after this. Stick with us.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game. Hollywood Squares, Dollar.
What
is the
fastest
new game show
on television?
Go!
What you play just can't stop. Go weekdays on NBC.
Now go beyond clean, all the way to shine. Introducing new dishwasher oil. Now it has a new advanced formula that's better than it ever was before. So hardworking, new dishwasher oil not only cleans, it makes everything shine. All gets dishes dazzling, silverware shimmer.
Now back to John Feldman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. Okay, welcome back. Our next game is going to be worth $200 plus $25 for every square that you capture. Now, the last game was won by Laurie Gause. So, Stacy Turner, pick a star.
Bill Daly.
Oh, thank you. Oh, wow. I bought this coat and everything. I'm glad I got on.
Bill is underwhelmed. Bill, who is the author of the book titled Explaining China? Is it Richard Nixon or Steve Allen?
Explaining China.
Mm-hmm.
Let me see. Steve wrote a book. He wrote a thing on China. You know, come to think about it, I emceed the Steve Allen show. It was discovered by him, and I lived at his house for 6 weeks while he went to China and wrote the book. It was definitely Steve Allen.
Okay.
But thank you for picking me. That was real nice.
Side star.
So Bill Daly says that Steve Allen wrote the book Explaining China. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
Steve Allen it is. Yeah, you are right to agree, and you get the square.
$25.
That is
a true story, though.
That was true.
Knows everything.
Was
it awfully convincing.
No, really, honestly.
Oh, it's one story.
Okay, Laurie, where would you like to go?
Okay, let's go with Jimmy again.
Yay! Yippee!
Many women have tried to go with Jimmy, and few have failed.
Never again.
Okay, Jimmy, which is bigger, an average ostrich egg or Mr. T's head?
Well,
you know, Mr. T is my man.
Jimmy.
You know, I can't talk about T. You know, brother man. You know, just in case something happened to T, I'm going on the B team. I don't want to take no shots. Let me see. Mr. T's head on ostrich egg. That's an interesting thing. Now, see, it looks like some obvious things. That's why I have to go against the obvious and go more with a rambunctious answer, which is more correct, though.
Here we go again.
Do you have an answer?
I think
a rambunctious correct answer.
Ostrich egg, because the obvious answer would be to get on my man, Mr. T, with the mohawk.
Okay. Jimmy Walker says that an ostrich egg is, in fact, bigger than Mr. T's head. Agree or disagree, Lori?
I'm going to agree with him.
The answer is Mr. T's head. You should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that.
I'm
you
sorry.
Didn't say including the hair.
Who took the measurements?
That's right. Yeah, Mrs. Really. T. Mrs. T.
Mrs. T. Okay, Stacy, take a look at the board and pick a star.
Phil Proctor, please.
Phil in the middle.
Phil in the middle. Phil in the middle. That's very funny.
Oh. Which British... wasn't meant to be, and it wasn't. Which British rock group was once known as Johnny and the Moondogs?
A British... The Who? Oh, that's my answer.
Yeah. I was waiting for you to say that. Stacy, he says The Who was once known as Johnny and the Moondogs.
Agree?
Disagree. The answer is The Beatles. You're right to disagree, and you get another square.
First answer was the Beatles, but I didn't know it was really the Beatles.
Hey, that's why I like doing the show. I learn something new every time.
It's true. Educational.
Lori Gause, where would you like to go? Take a good look at this.
Gene Rayburn to block.
Wow.
All right. Mm. Now, if you get this question correct, you will block. However, should you miss this question, Stacy will get an X and win the game. Also, I have to point out that although Gene Rayburn is the host of the match game portion of our show, he has never seen any of the Hollywood Squares questions.
And vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get a list of both?
He means I've never seen any of the match game questions.
A little just touch kidding. Of humor there.
Just kidding. I came in late. I'm sorry.
I knew we'd never get away with all that. Yes, but it's all true. Gene is the longest running musical in Broadway history. It is the longest running musical in Broadway history. What show is it?
I tell you, I've been a fan of that show from day one. I've seen it 7 times. I saw it in London. I saw it in Los Angeles. Saw it 5 times. I've seen it 7 times altogether. It's The Chorus Line.
He says it's A Chorus Line.
I will agree. Excuse
me. The answer is A Chorus Line. You're right to agree, and you get the block. Well, we've got a pretty hot game going here, and we're going to be back to finish it right after this.
I live to eat, and eat to live, with everything seasoned perfectly. Herbs, spices, and no salt. Aha, you seasoned no salt. It's full of great tastes, like paprika, celery.
If you tell me which bag has the new trail bars.
New trail, good tasting granola bars.
Oh boy, we're in the middle of a hot game. The score is 200 for Lori so far, 100 for Stacy. However, Stacy, it's your turn at bat, and you have a critical game situation. Where would you like to go?
Twyla Littleton, please.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Twyla Littleton for a game win.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Twyla.
That's weird.
You're a dog.
She is a dog. She is a
dog.
I can't believe this sentence.
No dog.
Why did they put this question in the wrong place?
I have to go to my dressing
room. Well, look, it just says you're a dog and your nose is cold and wet.
Well, that part's true.
That's right.
Yeah, her nose is cold and wet.
Does this mean that you are healthy or does it mean nothing at all?
It's a very good question, and it definitely means that you are very healthy as a dog.
Okay, so Twyla says...
Not you personally, and not me personally, but if you are a dog, yes, definitely.
Twyla says that if a dog's nose is cold and wet, it means that the dog is healthy. Agree or disagree, Stacy, for the game?
I agree.
She agrees. Well, the answer is that it means nothing at all. No, you should have disagreed. Okay.
That's right.
Lori Gause. Lori Gause, bark me a star.
Skip.
You ever live on the farm?
Okay, Skipper.
You ever get cold nosed? No,
big Skipper. We didn't have farms.
Well, they do now, though.
Hey, right on the subject. Where would you find more pigs, in Iowa or in Hawaii?
There's a discotheque down on Lankerson Boulevard that's back every night.
It's not one of your choices.
No.
Iowa or Hawaii?
You find more pigs in Iowa or Hawaii?
Mm-hmm.
On the island of Hawaii.
Okay, so Skip says it's Hawaii. You agree or disagree with Hawaii, Lori?
I think I'll disagree.
The answer is Iowa. You're right to disagree, and you get the square.
Mr. Nebraska, huh?
Wow. Hawaii than Iowa, huh? Oh, farm boy.
She's come back with a vengeance, Stacy. Take a good look at the board and tell me where you'd like to move.
Allison Arnstrom to block, please.
Mm-hmm.
Arn Grimm. You'll learn.
I could have told you that. Just
okay.
If you get this right, you will block. However, if you don't, Lori will get the square and win the game. Allison, You are going through the change of life.
I beg your pardon. I'm 21 years old.
Calling her a dog? Yeah, come on.
Anyway, the answer is
you're going through the change of life, Allison, and you're having a hot flash.
And a cold nose.
Now, you are probably going to feel heat around what three parts of your body?
Ow!
I'm going to give you two of them.
That is a hot flash.
You're going to be ahead of the game.
How long
does
it last?
Okay, two of the parts are your face and your neck. What's the third place?
Ooh, watch it.
Where do I usually get a hot flash? My face, my neck?
Probably Iowa.
Let me see.
Well, it's not you. It's somebody who's going through change of life.
I don't know. That felt pretty good.
The wrists, you know,
stand
blood.
With some practice,
okay.
Please.
Okay, so Allison says, Allison says that the three places are the face, the neck, and hers is the wrists. Agree or disagree, Stacy?
I disagree.
The answer is your chest. You were right to disagree, and you get the square. Your turn up. Now, I might point out to you that Stacy, your opponent, has four X's. If someone gets five of their respective symbol during our game, they will win the game. That means that if you miss this question, she will get another X and take the game.
Hello? School's out! Yay!
Forget all of that, because that bell means the time is up. With $250, Lori Goss, you're our winner! So close. Okay, congratulations, Lori. Why don't you go over there and get set for your shot at the big money? Such a good contestant on Match Game Hollywood Squares. Thank you. And now, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Congratulations to our champion here. We'll be back with our nine celebrities and the big money right after this.
Only one dressing can wear this label.
Lori, you ready for that?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, Lori, and we said, give us your best answer to this. Ronald Blank. Now, the top answer is worth $1,000. The second most popular answer is worth $500. And the third answer, $250. You can enlist the aid of any three of our nine celebrities to give you suggestions. Who do you want to call on first?
Let's go with Jimmy.
Of course, and why not? My main man and my number one cat, a cat who's been leading the country in many wonderful things, Ronald McDonald.
Ronald McDonald. All right. That's one. Okay, no. Who else do you want?
John?
Yeah, of course, this is the guy that makes hamburger, well, actually mincemeat out of everything, Ronald Reagan.
All right. That's two.
Allison. Ronald McDonald, Ronald Reagan. I was thinking of that. The only other Ronald that I know of, and I guess you know him too, Ronald Coleman.
Yeah. Ronald Coleman, a wonderful motion picture star of yesteryear.
Great president, too.
Right. Yeah. Ronald McDonald, Ronald Reagan, and Ronald Coleman. You may choose one of those now, or you may think up one of your own and use that.
Think up one of your own. Go ahead.
No.
Ronald McDonald.
Ronald McDonald. All right, let's find out how you did. We're going to see if Ronald McDonald is up there, and if so, where. Let's go down to the bottom and reveal a $250 response.
Hey,
Ronald Coleman.
Hey.
I told you. Very good, Allison.
Well, he's
working. All right. Let's take a look at the $500 response.
Yep.
Ronald McDonald. That's your answer. That gives you $500. Now, just what do you think is under the big one?
What if it wasn't?
Reagan. All right, let's slide it.
Oh,
Ronald Reagan.
Yeah. What a surprise.
Okay. So far, you have $500. There it is, $500 up there.
Nice.
Now, you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing here. Each star has in front of him a hidden number, a 10, a 20, a 30. If you pick a star with a 10, we'll multiply your money by 10. If your star has a 20, we'll multiply your money by 20. And there is one star up there with a 30. And if you pick him or her, you'll play for 30 times that amount. Okay, time to make your pick.
Let's go, Jimmy.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, Jimmy, she's chosen you. And that means I ask you now to see your hidden number. Go. Go. A 10. All right, it's a 10. That means you're playing the head-to-head for...
Let's hit it.
10 times that amount or $5,000.
Let's hit it.
All right.
All right.
Now, you face me if you would, please. Jimmy, you're going to write your answer to this if you would, please. Here it is. Share the blank. Share the blank. All right, Maury. Jimmy is ready. Your job is to match him. What do you put in that blank to collect that whole bundle there of $5,000?
Money's on my mind, so let's go share the money.
Share the money. All right, Jimmy, she says share the money will match you for $5,000. What do you say?
Almost something close to share the wealth.
Share the wealth is a very good response. Share the money was also good. Well, listen, it's not a total loss because you're going to play another game. You're going to come back as the reigning champion, and you already have $750, which is yours for sure for Keith. Congratulations to you very much, Laurie. All right. We'll be back in a moment or so right after these messages for you.
Hour. Just send the postcard to contestants. The match game, Hollywood Squares Hour, 6430 Sunset Boulevard, Hollywood, California, 90028.
All right. Here we're standing with our reigning champion. She'll be back to play again tomorrow. She's got $750 now. And she and I and John are curious as to where the big number is. Which celebrity had the 30? Would you reveal them now?
I'll pull my own.
Would you go over there and reveal yours? John had a 10, 10, 20. Bill Daly had the 30.
I got the 30,000?
Yeah.
You get the card, Bill.
Listen, there's one thing I got to say. Barbie, I'm sorry that you are not called out, but that's the way this game goes.
That's
John,
we'll call on her
can
later.
Can we pay her anyway?
Yes, in our room, we're calling on her.
So we're going to pay you anyway, even though you didn't get the chance to work today. But there's one thing, since Steve Allen was a subject of one of the questions earlier, there are two gentlemen on the panel who imitate his laughter. May we hear them one at a time? Bill, would you like to go first? Steve, can we just hold him? He's got for a second. One more time, Bill. Thank you, Steve Allen. Phil? Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you all. That ends today's session of the Match Game Hollywood Square Hour. We'll be back tomorrow with our champion here and all nine celebrities. I'll be here for the Match Game.
And I'll be here for the Hollywood Squares.
So long to the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
Goodbye.
Microwave oven featuring computerized cooking with three memory levels lets you automatically program exactly the right temperature, power, and cooking time for any foods furnished by Roper. And some of our departing contestants will receive sidewalk motocross run by Hedstrom, knobby tires, mag wheels on a 16-inch bike from Hedstrom we put fun on wheels, Uncle Ben's international flavored rices, chicken, beef, curd, and pilaf, and really the best we'll do, say Uncle Ben's. Polynex smoke grab a no smoke ashtray automatically helps trap smoke from idling cigarettes or cigars on ashtrays. 20 Mule Team Borax, a natural for freshening and cleaning all family wash, and it's handy for many household cleaning chores. Equal is the revolutionary low calorie sweetener with a natural taste of sugar with no saccharin, no bitter aftertaste. Furnished by Equal.
For the latest events in Beirut, the Caribbean, and around the world, go where the news is.
Training series, I'm sure you'll agree.
It's a game for the uninhibited. Our stars this week, Vicki Lawrence and Jamie Farr. Watch their bodies do the talking on Body Language. And here's the star of Body Language, Tom Kennedy.
Hi there. Yes, yes, that's right. Hello there. Thank you very much. Welcome. Thank you. So happy to have you with us. Our show is called Body Language. It's a game for the uninhibited. Let's meet our players.
Hey, Vicki Lawrence is with us, and I'm so proud and happy. Good to see you. Thank you for being with us on this very special week. These are old stomping grounds for you, aren't they? This stage here at CBS? Are.
Carol.
With Carol Burnett.
Yeah.
Then, of course, you went over to that other network with Mama's Family. Mm-hmm. And now she's on cable with the Perfect American... What is the
Great American Homemaker, but I am perfect.
Of course you are.
You're right.
Who is this lady? Jean, what is your last name?
Paige.
Hi, Jean Paige. Tell us about yourself. There's your welcome.
I'm originally from Buffalo, New York, and I've been out here a year, and I'm waitressing and enjoying California. And...
Well, good. It's a little bit warmer out here than Buffalo.
Oh, it's a lot warmer out here.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, from Aftermath, the star, Jamie Farr.
Thank you. Hey, that rhymes. Thank you, Thomas. Incidentally, Aftermath is going to be moved to Tuesday nights in the fall. We're going to be on opposite the A-team. So if you want to watch this, please turn to CBS.
That's what I heard.
Yes.
Oh, you'll kill those guys.
No, don't be too sure. That's a good show.
You didn't hear what he said when I came out. When I came out through those doors, it looks like an elevator. You know, campus shop, all up. And he says, you sure you got the right floor? Jamie, good to see you,
Thank you. You know my friend Gary, Indiana?
Oh, Gary, how are you? What's your last name?
My last name is Sale.
Gary Sales, yeah. Tell us about yourself.
Gary, I'm from Atchison, Kansas. I moved out here. I'm currently a counselor and a security officer.
Well, welcome aboard. Good luck to all of you. The object of body language is to act out, folks, a series of words to help you solve a puzzle. It's just that easy. Vicki, we're going to start with your team.
Yes,
that simple. Vicki, we're going to start with your team. So, Vicki, you're out there in the acting arena. Go out that way. Jean, you come right over here in behind the podium.
I certainly will.
Where did they go?
Oh. I don't know, but I don't need them.
All right.
I do everything That's better with my bare feet, Tom.
This kid speaks good body language. Here's what we're going to do now. We're going to show you five words that will fit into a puzzle, and you'll see that puzzle a little bit later on. Now, you have to use body language, as you know, to act out as many words as you can for Jean to guess. Yeah. And the more words she guesses, the easier it will be to solve that puzzle. We're going to show you the words one at a time. You'll have 60 seconds to act out as many as possible. You can pass any time you want. We'll come back to that word if there is time remaining. Could we have 60 seconds, please? This girl is anxious to go to work. Here is the first word, and go.
Okay, you're Richard Nixon.
You gotta keep, next word.
Something round, and you're pushing something into it, a bag, a garbage bag, pushing something into a trash compactor.
You can pass, Pass, next word.
You're walking, you're drunk, you're paralyzed, you are pointing directions, you're giving directions, walk this way.
You can pass, next word.
You're a soldier, you're a ship, you're a statue, you're the Statue of Liberty.
You got it, next word.
Pass.
Yeah, next word. Now we're repeating, Jean.
Pushing something into a bag, shoving it in there, cramming, jamming, shoving laundry, dirty laundry into the hamper.
You got 7 seconds.
Pushing.
Jean, oh, you. That was good. Was that good? Here's one. There's the other. I don't say anything because this puzzle hasn't been solved yet, but that's... Oh, yeah, I know. Don't know. I love it. Sit down over there, if you would. Sit down over there. Oh, my goodness. Jean, we'll explain all that later. Here's what's important to you. You got two words. Now we're going to show you this puzzle we've been talking about. And could we see that puzzle? Here's the way it goes. Now, you see, blank of blank and blank in a blank blank are blank of this blank.
Now, okay.
The audience probably knows what that is, but you may not, Jean. But you did earn two words. So we're going to put those two words in. Can we see those? The first word that she earned was statues. Oh, that's very good, right up front. And the next one was what? Oh, yes, Richard Nixon. Now, statues of Richard Nixon and blank in a blank blank are blank of this blank. I don't know if that helps you, but if it does, and you get it, you get $100.
I know it.
Time is up. Don't say anything, and that means that Gary's in the game. Come over here, Gary.
All right.
Now, since she didn't get it on the first one, here's what we're going to do. No pantomime for you. You're going to now reveal another blank. We'll go back and forth between you until you solve the puzzle. Which blank would you like?
Number five.
All right, number five. He's been studying this. Statues of Richard Nixon and blank in the blank museum or blank this. Gary?
I would say Washington, D.C.
Is it Washington, D.C.? No, it isn't, but they're not that sure. Gene. Gene, 3, 4, 6, or 7. Which next?
I'll take 7.
Number 7. Does that help her? Yeah. Museum or blank of this stuff? What do you think, Gene?
Collections.
Is it collections? You're still in the game, Gary. Which blank?
Number 3.
3. Statues of Richard Nixon and John Wayne in a blank museum. What do you think, Gary?
I would say marble.
Oh, is it marble? It's not. Now, we have 2 blanks left. Gene, what, take a blank.
First. I'll take number 4.
Number 4, Richard Nixon and John Wayne in a Hollywood museum or blank of this stuff.
Wax.
Is it wax for $100?
That's what it is. You're thinking of the real thing, marble.
And number 6 is made, right, made of this stuff. Now, Gene, I want you to tell me how... Vicky, come here for just a second, please. How could you possibly... If I ever saw the quintessential impersonation of John Wayne, it was this. Now, how can you look at that and not get John Wayne? I can't understand it. That was beautiful. But you ended up winning anyway. The first team, incidentally, to reach $500 wins our game and a chance for $10,000. That's how we play our game. We'll be back with Jamie Farr's team right after this. Don't go away.
Imagine a day without allergies, without sinus.
Lawrence's team 100 to Jamie's nothing, but Jamie hasn't had a chance yet.
Not yet, but she was great as John Wayne.
Really?
She was just wonderful.
Yes. Now, I bet you can do it. We won't talk about
that.
Because it may be coming up. I bet if you do a great Durante.
Yeah.
I'll just take a chance on that.
I have to run back and get some makeup, get a fake nose.
Jamie, we're going to show you a new puzzle. This is also going to be worth $100. We're going to show you 5 words, see how many Gary's going to get. Okay? 60 seconds on the clock. Here's the first word.
Go.
Tall, high.
Yes, next word.
Shoot, you're putting on something. You're taking off. You're undressing. You're stripping. Stripping. You're a stripper. You're a striptease artist.
Yes, now, go.
All right. You're staring.
Yes,
you're staring
at next word.
You're undressing again. A peeping Tom.
Yes, next word. Yeah. You're repeating now. Last word, rather. Last word.
A majorette. A band leader. A picketer. A picket sign. A strike. A protest.
Yes, you got them all with 18 seconds left. Way to go! Way to go! Sit down over there. You know what bothers me? He did that peeping Tom too well. Too well. You not only got all 5 words, you had about 18 seconds left over.
That fell in love.
Yeah. All right, Gary, now you got 5 words. That ought to give you this puzzle. First of all, let's take a look at the puzzle. Now, let's take a look at the 5 words you have earned. One of them was peeping Tom, which he did extremely well. Stare, got that one right off the bat. Striptease, which I think he invented. And you got 2 more. Protest, got that at the last. And high. Now, it reads, peeping dared to stare when she did a strip tease on her blank for $100. Gary, what do you think?
Lady Godiva.
Is it Lady Godiva? You got it. Boy, this guy plays the game. Can we see the rest of the puzzle? Rest of the puzzle, please. A striptease on her horse to protest high taxes. Yes, sir. This guy knows how to play our game. At the end of the first round on body language, the score is $100 apiece. 2 hot teams up here. Back with body language right after this. Way to go.
Everybody loves a piping hot dinner. But by the time you finally eat...
$100 apiece. Now, the game... is $500. So in this round, each puzzle will pay $250. If neither team makes it to 500, then we'll have a playoff game. Okay? Here we go. Gene, we have 60 seconds now. We're going to put on the clock. Good luck to you.
Thank you.
$250 puzzle. Here is the first word, and go.
You're driving a car. You're sitting, it's a tricycle, a bicycle. You're on a little tiny car, a little midget, Autopia. The
midget car.
Take it back. Pass. Next word.
You're scolding. You're telling your children. You're lecturing. Yes.
Pass. Next word.
It's loud. It's noisy.
We gave that to you. Go ahead. That's good enough.
Little next tiny word. Teeny.
Yes. Pass. Next word.
You're riding a horse. You're Santa Claus. You're a reindeer.
Yes. Next word.
You're
this is a repeat.
You're sitting in a
repeat.
Little car. You're driving a little toy truck, a little wagon. It's like a wagon. It's a tricycle bicycle. You've got something over the top of it.
Two words left. This one and the other. God, okay, here's the other word now. Repeating.
Please. You're a mother and you're lecturing and you've got a pointed hat. You're done. You're an elf.
You got it. Here's the last word now.
You're driving.
Oh, ran out of time. Ran out of time. Yes. Don't know how you could have conveyed, but I'll talk to you about it in a minute. You look closer than you think. You got four of them. Four out of five. That's darn good. Can we see the next puzzle? $250 puzzle this one is. Let's take a look, Vicki, at the four words you earned. Here's the first one, tiny. And the next one is reindeer. Yeah. And pointed. And the fourth one was noise. Here we go. A blank has a tiny one that goes blank, but a reindeer has pointed blank ones that don't make any noise. Vicki, for $250.
Blank ones that don't make a what has a tiny one that goes.
Your time is up, Jamie. Get up here. Jamie Farr is now in the game. No more pantomime, Jamie. Just pick a blank.
I like number six.
Okay. But a reindeer has pointed fancy ones that don't make any noise.
Horn?
Is it horn?
Oh, sure it is.
It is horn, yeah. He wasn't sure.
I wasn't sure.
That's right.
Is that a duck or a goose that has a tiny one that goes honk?
Let's see what it is. Can we see the rest of the puzzle? It's a Volkswagen. That's that little tiny car she was talking about. It has a tiny one that goes beep. But a reindeer has pointed fancy ones that don't make any noise. $350 for the guys, $100 for the gals, and we have another $250 puzzle, don't we? So that means that Vicki, you sit down. Jamie, you stay here.
Okay.
Vicki, you over there. Gary, come on out here. Now, since you have $350, here's the score. Since you have $350, if you get this $250 puzzle, you guys win the game. If the gals get it, they tie the score. You all set?
All set.
All right. You're all set. Here's 60 seconds on the clock. Here's the first word, Gary, and go.
You are punching something, ripping something open. You've got a knife. You're stabbing. You're cutting, stabbing. You're the murderer.
Yes. Next word.
It's something coming from the heavens. It's a fly ball. Catcher's mitt. A baseball mitt.
You got it. Next
outfielder's
word.
Mitt. You're kneading something. You're putting it in the oven. Are you baking? You're the baker.
You got it. Next word.
You're thinking. You're taking you're a brain surgeon.
You've got it. Next word. This is the last word.
You have a mustache. You're the villain. You're ripping a, up. You're in disguise. You have a disguise.
Yes, you got it. Sit down over there. Way to go. Way to go, Jamie. With seconds left over. If you get this, win the game. Could we see the puzzle, please? You got all five of them. Here are the five words. Look at them carefully. Here's the first one. Baker. Next was disguise. Good. Last one you got. Catch. Two more to go. Murderer and brain. This blank player from Baker Street used a disguise to catch the murderer, but his brain made him a great blank. If you get this, you win the game. What is it, Jamie?
I say, Watson, it's probably Sherlock Holmes.
Is it Sherlock Holmes? It is Sherlock Holmes. Well done, Mr. Clark. Well done, old boy. And well done, Gary. $600. That wins the game. Come on over here. Oh, you guys are terrific.
Thank you, Doug.
Gene, we have to say goodbye to you. She played the game beautifully. You won, what did you win? $100 plus some nice gifts. Thank you for playing our game. And as for you guys, you won so far $600, and we're going to be back to play for you, sir, for a possible, in addition to the $600, $10,000. Do that after this.
Thank you.
Get ready to play. Johnny Carson, Raquel Welch, Muhammad Ali, Barbara Streisand, Warren Beatty. You just never know who's going to drop by.
Our winning team, Jamie Farr and Gary Sayles, and our first winning team, I guess I should say. Gary, you have won, and you have earned $600. And now it's time for you to take a shot at what we call our body language sweepstakes, where you can win, in addition to the $600, up to $10,000. Jamie Farr is already out here in acting position. Mr. Farr.
Yes, sir, Mr. Kennedy.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to give you now 10 words, one at a time. You will have 60 seconds to act out as many words as you can. And as for you, Gary, incidentally, you can pass on these words if you want.
And then come back as long as I have the remaining time.
You've seen the show.
No, I listened to you.
Oh, good. Gary, for every word you get $100, you see? And then when time is up, we'll give you then a chance to change that $100 into $1,000. Or rather, from hundreds into thousands, up to 10. All set?
All that sounds good to me.
Are you ready, Mr. Farr?
Yes, sir.
May we have 60 seconds, please? Here is the first word. Go.
Are you smoking?
You got it. Next word.
Are you shooting dice?
Yes. Next word. $200 so far.
You're digging. You're hoeing. You're spading. Shovel.
That's $300.
You're playing. You're playing an instrument, a harp.
That's $400.
You're a juggler.
That's $500.
A mirror.
$600.
You're combing your hair, but you have dandruff on your
shoulder. $700. 27 seconds left.
You're a guy. an anchor. You're throwing
yes,
an anchor.
Yes, $800. Two left with 17.
You're carrying a bag, a suitcase, a valise, a picnic.
You have $900.
We're talking waterbeds here.
You got 10 of them.
You had 6 seconds left over.
Oh, my gracious.
Mr. Cool, he's so, hey, we're talking
water. Yeah, I like that, yeah. Oh, I got seasick on that one, the acre in a waterbed.
Incidentally, earlier in the show, when you saw some words that came up that weren't the exact form, they were forms of the words, that's why we were giving them to him. I don't even remember what I'm talking about now, but you know what I'm talking about at home. You got 10 words. That's $1,000. That can now be transformed into $10,000. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to give you, Mr. Farr, 20 seconds to act out, this time, three words. Gary, you must get all three. If you do, the 1,000 becomes 10,000. If you don't get all three, you still have the $1,000. You understand? Here we go. 20 seconds. Here is the first word. Go.
You're putting on lipstick.
There's one. Two to go.
You're putting on a pair of pants, a girdle.
There's two, one to go.
You fainted.
You got all three for $10,000. Money here.
Party.
$10,000. What are you going to do with it, Gary?
Party a little bit.
Party a little bit. What did you say you did for a living?
I'm a counselor and a security officer.
Now retired. Oh.
At least for a week, a month.
You know we played well. I must say, great teamwork all the way around. You have a grand total so far, and you're not leaving. You have a grand total of $10,600 for our security officer here and our salesman. You did say salesman. Oh,
counselor.
Oh, counselor. What do you counsel, Gary?
I'm not supposed to say it.
Oh, you're not? Oh, okay. Well, they've counseled him not to say that. We'll be right back right after these words. $10,600 for this young man right here. Take my word for it.
The amazing Daredevil roommate vacuum is our...
We're about out of time for today. I just want to say it's a great way to uncork our show. Gary Sayles walking away with $10,600. And, of course, he'll be back tomorrow with these same two beautiful personalities. We hope you join us tomorrow. Hope you all had a good time, did you? We sure did. Vicki Lawrence is going to be here tomorrow. Jamie Farr is going to be here. And we'll look for you. See you next time on Body Language.
Bye-bye. Some of our departing contestants will receive Westminster Crazy.
This is our champion, Mary Moorhead, and her two new opponents. Today, she'll be trying for her second chance to win one of these five 1972 Chevrolets. The four-seat Camaro Sport Coupe, the Vega Camback Wagon, the Chevelle Malibu Convertible, the Kingswood Estate six-passenger station wagon, or the classic Corvette Stingray. Today on Split Second. And now, the host of our show, Tom Kennedy.
Hello there. Well, I tell you, friends, Monday we gave away a car. Beginning of a great new week, we haven't given away a car since Monday. As a result of that, our cash jackpot is up to $600. You see, every day the car is not given away, we add $200. It's up to $600 now, so Mary Moorhead is back for her second try. Yesterday she won, but the car didn't start, did it, Mary?
It didn't start.
She's back today. If you win today, you will have a 1 out of 4 chance to win a car. You will also have a chance of that $600, but first of all, you have to take on two new opponents, two fine young gentlemen. Jack, who are they, please, sir?
Well, the first gentleman, Tom, is married and a publication editor from Burbank, California, Craig Cook. And another bachelor, a writer from New York City, Michael Rusnow.
Okay, Craig and Michael, welcome, gentlemen. As you probably know, Craig and Michael, in this first round, if you have a single answer, it's worth $25. If two of you have the right answer, $10 apiece. If all three of you have the right answer, it's $5 apiece. And let's get right into our first round. The first category is people. Give me the first names of the three first ladies who directly preceded Jackie Kennedy in the White House. Michael.
Mamie Eisenhower.
Right. And Craig.
Lady Bird Johnson.
That is wrong. And Mary?
Beth Truman.
That is right. And Eleanor Roosevelt before her. And Lady Bird came after right. Jackie. Yes. Two correct answers. $10 for Michael, $10 for Mary. Look at the board. Title character, principal villain, principal fairy. Match each of these with the correct name in James M. Barrie's famous... All right, Michael.
Peter Pan.
Match them.
Title character.
That is right. Here's the rest of the question now. In James M. Barrie's famous tale about a little boy who would not grow up. Mary, you're next.
The principal fairy is Tinkerbell.
That is right. We're now looking for the principal villain, Craig.
Principal villain was Captain Hook.
Yes, it was. Captain Hook. Three correct answers. $5 apiece. And now look at the board. It says there L blank E, C blank E, and B blank D. Fill in these blanks to get three foods, all slang words for money. Mary.
BD is bread.
That's right. Craig.
CE is cabbage.
That's right. And Michael, what do you think?
LE is lettuce.
You're all three right. You know a lot about money. $5 apiece. Let's take another look at this board. It says LA Lakers star. She done him wrong and the day of the locust. Each of these is a clue to a celebrity whose last name is West. Match each of the correct Craig.
L.A. Lakers star, Jerry West.
That's right. First name, Michael.
She done him wrong, Mae West.
That is right. Mary, what do you think? That's the day of the locust.
I think that's a hard question.
I think you're right. It's Nathaniel West. We have two correct answers, $10 for each of the gentlemen. And let's see who is our leader. We almost didn't have one. Michael, you just made it. Mr. Michael Rusnow is our leader, and we'll have more of round one right after this. We continue with round one. The Funk and Wagnalls is one of the sources used for questions on our show. Michael Rusnow is our leader with $30, and Craig Cook and Mary Moorhead are tied for second place with $20 apiece. This is personality. Name the three husbands of Norma Jean Baker, better known as Marilyn Monroe. Mary?
Joe DiMaggio.
That is right. Craig?
Arthur Miller.
That is right. Michael?
Joe Simpson.
No, I'm sorry. No, it was James Doherty. Two correct answers, $10 for Craig and 10 for Mary. And now look at the board, Scarlet Ibis. No, that's all right. That was the last one. We'll get away with that one. Can you pull another one there? There you go. Beautiful. How smooth can you get, huh? Scarlet Ibis, Scarlet Pimpernel, and Scarlet Tanager. Tanager. Choose one of these and tell me yes or no. Is it the name of a bird, Mary?
Scarlet Tanager, yes.
That is right. And Michael, you're next.
A Scarlet Pimpernel, no.
That's right. It's an herb or a dashing hero. Craig, we're looking for Scarlet Ibis. Yes.
Scarlet Ibis, no.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yes, it is. It is a bird. So we had one single answer, and Mary Moorhead, that means $25. Oh, wait a minute. We have two correct answers. $10 for Mary and $10 for Michael. All right. All you Michael Rusnow friends corrected me on that. Aha! And Michael and Mary are tied for first place. And now look at the board. Mr. Magoo, Bugs Bunny, and Underdog. Match these three cartoons. Mary.
Underdog is Wally Cox.
By golly, that's right. Match the cartoon characters with the actor who does his voice. Michael, you're next.
Bugs Bunny, Mel Blanc.
That's right. Mr. Magoo is left there, Craig.
Can't think of it.
Jim Backett.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, it is? Okay.
Absolutely.
All right. Two correct answers. 10 for Michael, 10 for Mary. Look at the board. Leatherneck, Dog Face, and Swab Jockey. Match each of these common nicknames with the branch of Woo Craig.
Leatherneck is a Marine.
That is right. With the U.S. service to which it refers. Mary.
Dog Face Army.
That is right. And Michael.
Swab Jockey Navy.
That is right. And incidentally, to all members of all services, these are only nicknames. And those are three correct answers, $5 apiece. Mary and Michael are still tied for first place. Transportation. Give me the three means of transportation used by the American petroleum industry to transport oil over land, Craig.
Pipeline.
That's right, Mary.
Railroad.
That is correct, Michael.
Camel.
You got the wrong show. You're looking for Can You Top This? It's right down the hall. It's truck. Two correct answers. I like it, though, Mike. I like your style. 10 for Craig and 10 for Mary. Mary is now our leader. Mary is our leader. Michael is second. And now look at the board. His favorite, Forrest. His sweetheart, his enemy, Sheriff. Mary.
His sweetheart was Maid Marian.
That is right. Match these items with the relevant facts about Robin Hood. Michael?
His favorite forest, Sherwood.
That's right. Craig,
his enemy sheriff was the Sheriff of Nottingham.
That is correct. All three of you are right on that $5 apiece. Look at the board. Shana Tova, Banani, and Gudas Noyas Yar. All three mean Happy New Year. Match each with its... Oh, Michael?
Banane French.
That is right. With its language, Mary?
The bottom one is German.
Gudas Noyas Yar is German. That's right. Craig, Shana Tova is next. That's Hebrew. Two correct answers, $10 for Michael and $10 for Mary. Mary is still our leader. Michael's in second place. And now look at the board. St. John, St. James, and St. Jacques. Match each of these famous show business saints with his or her first Mary.
Jill St. John.
Name, that is right. Craig, you're next.
Raymond St. Jacques.
That's right. Michael St. James is next.
Patrick St. James.
No, it's Susan St. James. She is currently co-starring with, what's her name, Rock Hudson, right? Okay, two correct answers, $10 for Craig, $10 for Mary. And the time is up, and Mary Moorhead is our leader with $90. Going into round two, wherein we double our stakes. That comes up right after this. In round two, we double the stakes, $50 for a single correct answer, $25 each if two of them have the right answer, $10 apiece if all three have the right answer. Mary is our leader, $90, Michael second with $70, and Craig Cook third with $60. Next category, show business. Based on actual receipts at the box office, give me the names of the three most successful currently operating ice shows in the United States. Mary.
Ice Cave.
Right. Craig.
Ice Follies.
Right. And Michael.
Madison Square Garden?
No, sir. It's Holiday on Ice. Two correct answers. 25 for Mary, 25 for Craig. Look at the board. Cardin, Saint Laurent, and Blass are three clothes makers, designers, I should say, whose names are found in Who's Who. Match each with his first name. Craig?
Bill Blass.
Right. Mary?
Pierre Cardin.
As correct. Michael?
Tyrone Blass.
Sir, as for Saint Laurent, it was Yves Saint Laurent. Yves is the correct answer. I didn't hear what you said, but I don't think it was anywhere near that, was it? You look bewildered, sir. Is there anything
I
can do?
No, that's okay. Continue.
You took Blass? He gave me that.
I'm sorry.
That was Bill Blass. That's okay. Only one answer per customer. $25 for Craig and $25 for Mary. Mary is in the lead. Craig is now in second place. Look at the board. It says they're Alaska, Florida, and Louisiana. Match these states with the countries from whom... Michael?
Alaska, Russia.
That's right. From whom the U.S. acquired them. Craig, you're next.
Louisiana, France.
Right. And Mary, Florida.
Florida, Spain.
That is correct. All three of you are right. $10 apiece. Look at the board. Charles Robb, Peter Lawford, and David Eisenhower. Each of these men is currently married to a girl with a famous father. Craig?
Charles Robb is the son-in-law of Lyndon Johnson.
That is right. Each with his well-known father-in-law. Michael?
David Eisenhower, Richard Nixon.
Right. Mary?
Peter Lawford, Dan Martin.
No, I'm sorry. It's Dan Rowan.
Oh.
And it's Dick Martin. And we have two correct answers, 25 for Craig and 25 for Michael. Mary is in the lead, but only by $5. Craig is right behind. Transportation. Not including the U.S., name the three countries which have the most miles of railroad track. Craig.
France.
Wrong. Mary.
England.
Wrong. Michael.
Russia.
That is right. And Canada and India. Russia, Canada, India. One single answer, $50 for Michael Rusnow. And to put him in the lead, 155. Would you look at those scores? 155, Mary 150, Craig 145. Look at the board. Smith, Vassar, Bryn Mawr. Match each of these colleges, mainly for women, with the state. Craig.
Bryn Mawr, Pennsylvania.
That's right. In which it is located. Mary.
Smith, New York.
Wrong. Michael.
Smith, Massachusetts.
That's right. And Vassar is in New York. Each of the gentlemen get $25 for that correct answer. And now Craig is in second place. Look at the board. Woodrow Wilson, William Howard Taft, Teddy Roosevelt. These three men ran for the presidency in 1912. Match them up with the animals that were the symbol. Mary.
Teddy Roosevelt, bull moose.
That is right. The symbols of their political parties. Michael.
William Howard Taft, elephant.
That's correct. Craig.
Woodrow Wilson, donkey.
You're all three right. $10 apiece. Very good. And now look at the board. Cover Girl, Funny Girl, and Georgie Girl. Match each of those movies with it. Michael.
Funny Girl, Barbara Streisand.
That's it. It's top female star, Craig.
Georgie Girl, Lynn Redgrave.
That is right. Mary?
Cover Girl, Rita Hayworth.
You're all three right again. $10 apiece. And Michael is still the leader. U.S. history now. Counting backwards from the Civil War, what were the three major wars in which the U.S. was involved? Craig?
War of 1812.
Right. Michael?
Mexican War.
Right. Mary, here's one more.
The Revolutionary...
You're all three right again. $10 apiece. What a contest. Look at the board. Radbipe, Nearleg, and Local Wrap. Remembering to match them up, unscramble each of these to come up with three army ranks. Craig.
Radbipe is private.
That's right. Mary.
Nearleg is general.
That's right. Michael.
Local Wrap is corporal.
You're all three right again. $10 apiece. Oh, boy. Michael's first, Craig is second, Mary's third. Look aboard. United States, Japan, Soviet Union. Pick one and tell me yes or no. Was it one of the original members of the League of Nations? Craig?
United States, yes.
I'm sorry, the United States, no. Mary?
Soviet Union, no.
That is right. That is correct. And Michael, you're next.
Japan, yes.
That is right. Two correct answers, 25 for Michael, 25 for Mary. And that puts Mary in second place. Look at the board. 12th, 40th, and 90th. Match each number with its correct spelling. Michael.
12th, T-W-E-L-P-T-H.
That is wrong. Craig, you're next.
40th, F-O-R-T-I-E-T-H.
That is right, Mary.
12th, T-W-E-L-T-H.
No, ma'am. T-W-E-L-F. T-H. And 90th, N-I-N-E-T-I-E-T-H. One single answer, $50 for Craig Cook. Puts you in the lead. This is a real ping-pong game. Craig is now in the lead. Michael is second. Mary is third. This is on Texas. We have 1 minute left in this round. Six different flags have flown over the territory, which is now the state of Texas. Name the three which did not belong to foreign countries. Craig.
Mexico.
Wrong. Michael.
United States.
That's it. Yes, I mean, that's one of them. Mary, I'm still waiting for answers. The other two were Republic of Texas and Confederate flag. One single answer, $50 for Michael Rusnow. Mike's back in the lead. Craig is second, Mary is third. Look at the board. 4 score, octave, and millennium. Match each with its numerical value. Michael.
4 score, 80.
Right. Mary.
Octave, 8.
Right. Craig.
Millennium, 1,000.
You're right, all three of you. $10 apiece. Look at the board. Time is up. At the end of round two, Michael Rusnow is our leader with $305. And you've gained the advantage going to the final countdown round. That comes up after this. You don't want to miss this one. Very tight contest today. Michael Rusnow is our leader going into the countdown round with $305. Michael, all you need is three answers to win our game. Craig Cook is second with $270. You need four answers to win. Mary Moorhead, our current champ, is in third place with $225. She needs five answers. I want to remind you of a couple of things. This time when you buzz in, you can give one, two, or all three of the answers. But wait for me to say correct before you continue. Then when you're recognized, be sure to come out with the answer because you only have 2 seconds per answer. So when you're recognized, come out with the answer. Good luck to all three. Michael, you could go on the very first question. It's on geography. Name the three European countries which border on the Adriatic Sea. Michael.
Greece.
Wrong. Mary.
Turkey.
Wrong. Craig.
Jakarta.
Wrong. They are Italy, Yugoslavia, and Albania. Greece is on the Ionian Sea. And now we look at the board. Ichabod Crane, Silas Marner, and Bob Cratchit. Match each literary character with his occupation. Michael.
Bob Cratchit, clerk.
Right, you may continue.
Ichabod Crane, teacher.
Right, you may continue. One more and you've won.
Silas Marner, weaver.
That's it, you've won the game. Now, that wasn't hard, was it, Michael?
Yes, it was.
Yeah, you bet it was. Very well done, Mr. Rusnow. Very well done indeed. What a tight contest, Craig and Mary. That was really fun. It really was. I'm sorry that everyone can't be a winner, but as you all know, you take home with you the money that you've earned up till now. Craig, for you, that means $270 in a well-played game, sir.
Thank you.
And Mary Moorhead, I'm sorry you didn't win, but you gave it a good try, and you won yesterday, won $300 today. You added to it $225. It gives you a total of $525. Your family can be proud of me. Well, thank you, Mary, and thank you, Craig. And Jack Clark, what else do we have from Mary and Craig in addition to that money?
Well, for each of them, Tom, we have from West Clocks, a solid-state wake-up-to-music alarm clock radio backed by years of manufacturing experience. A timely gift from West Clocks.
All right. So, Craig and Mary, thanks again. And now, Michael Rusnow, if you will join me center stage, as they say in showbiz. Mr. Rusnow, congratulations to you, sir. They tell me you're a bachelor, is that right?
That's right.
From?
From New York and Van Nuys.
New York and Van Nuys, yes. One's a suburb of the other. We have a jet plane. We have 5 cars back here, Michael. And one of those will work if you turn the key, if you pick the right car. We'll come back and learn of his decision, which one he's going to try right after this. Mr. Michael Rusnow just won his first game. They tell me you're a writer. How's the writing business these days?
Lousy.
Well, things are tough all over. We haven't given away a car for 4 days here, you know.
I'll try to break your record.
All right. Not only will you win a car if you pick the right one, Michael, but the jackpot is up to $600. That's in addition to the money you've earned.
$600, $1, a new car, the money you've won, all can be yours if you pick the right one. Which one do you want to go for?
The Kingswood Station Wagon.
The Kingswood Station Wagon. The biggie. Here we go. Let's find out.
All right, Michael, let's pick Chevy's Kingswood Estate Wagon with power steering, V8 engine, turbo hydromatic transmission, and power front disc brakes. All as standard equipment from Chevrolet.
No, not yet. Not till Tommy tells you. Now, you know, I don't know if you were watching the show yesterday, but Mary Moorhead came back here and tried this very car, and it was the one right next door. But that doesn't mean anything, because these cars each day are picked purely at random. You have as good a chance as anyone that this car will start. So good luck to you, Michael. Let's try it. I am sorry, Michael, this isn't the one. Jack Clark, which one is it today?
It was this little beauty in the middle here today.
Michael, you do win $305. What we have to do now is keep him away from sharp instruments until tomorrow. That was his second choice. If he wins, not tomorrow, Monday is what I meant to say, because we got a great weekend coming up. And Michael, you have a nice weekend.
Do you want a handkerchief?
Yes. And if you are successful Monday, I'm out of handkerchiefs. You'll have a 1 out of 4 chance, plus the $800 will be in the jackpot. All of you have a nice weekend, and I'm sure you will. And we'll see you then for Split Second. Bye-bye. That's all. You give it a try. Let's go over and take a look at this. Question is best provided by the 25-volume Clark & Wagnall's new encyclopedia from the world-renowned publishers of great reference works. The car that started today was selected entirely at random just prior to the beginning of today's program. If you'd like to be part of our studio audience and try out to be a contestant, write to Tickets, Split Second, in care of ABC TV, 4151 Prospect Avenue, Hollywood, California, 90027. Second is a Stephen Hayter's Monty Hall production. This is Jack Clark speaking.